Myo Plus provides the user with a significant increase to the intuitive control of their prosthetic hand. This is possible because Myo Plus learns how the user's phantom hand movements relate to the muscular activity of the residual limb. The Myo Cuff, a flexible electrode cuff that is applied quickly and easily, is used to determine if Myo Plus is suitable for the user. This step-by-step guide shows how the Myo Cuff and the Myo Plus app are set up to evaluate the user's individual movement patterns. Most amputees can still feel and move their phantom hand. These movements are called phantom hand movements. Phantom hand movements are associated with the muscle contractions of the residual limb, which are recognized by Myo Plus as movement patterns. Greater dexterity of the muscles and better visualization of the phantom hand lead to more movement patterns. As a result, enhanced prosthetic control is achieved. Individual movement patterns are therefore necessary for Myo Plus control. The Myo Cuff is used prior to the prosthetic fitting to evaluate how many movement patterns are possible. Turn on the Myo Cuff by pressing the charging receptacle for 2 seconds until the LED lights up green. The textile has been revised to support easier application of the Myo Cuff. There are now 2 hand symbols printed on the textile to clarify the application of the cuff on the right or left arm. In addition, a marking for the direction of the ulna and the electrode numbers from 1 to 8 were printed on the textile. Place the Myo Cuff with the new textile in such a way that the hand symbol is legible from the user's point of view. Then, rotate the Myo Cuff so that the ulna lies between electrode numbers 1 and 8. Electrode 1 must be positioned laterally so that the electrode number increases in the medial direction. As a result, the extensor muscles lie between electrode number 1 and 4, and the flexor muscles between electrode 5 and 8, regardless of whether the cuff is applied to a left or right forearm. If the Myo Cuff is always positioned this way, a comparison of the movement patterns from training to training or between different users is possible. Start the Myo Plus app by clicking the Myo Plus icon. Add a new Bluetooth connection by tapping on the plus icon. In case Bluetooth is not activated on your device, confirm the request dialog with Allow. Select the Myo Cuff by tapping on its serial number, which is printed on the PIN card that is delivered with the Myo Cuff. On the card, you will also find the PIN code that must be entered in the next step. Press Next. And if a Bluetooth pairing request pops up, confirm with OK. The app is now connected successfully to the Myo Cuff. By pressing Start App, you will be forwarded to the Clinician login page. Enter your username and PIN. These have been provided during certification. Define a personal password that can be used instead of the unlock PIN. Confirm with OK. You are now logged in as Clinician and will be forwarded to the Clinician settings. Here you can assign the name of the prosthesis. Select if an electric wrist rotator should be simulated and if the Myo Cuff is applied on the left or the right side. The number of electrodes is automatically recognized and displayed by the system. By pressing Basic Set, you will be forwarded to the Basic Set. Before the first recording, it is important to evaluate the user's movement patterns. Therefore, navigate to the Spiderplot. The Myo Plus app displays the user's current muscle activity in the form of a spiderplot. This visualization displays each electrode signal on an individual axis, so that the signals form a pattern. The signal intensities can be displayed by disabling pattern scaling. However, pattern scaling is recommended, as this magnifies the visualization, making it easier to see the difference between movement patterns. Well-separated movement patterns point in different directions and have little overlapping. While poorly separated movement patterns point in the same direction and overlap one another. If movement patterns are too similar, Myo Plus may not clearly identify the intended prosthetic movement. Initially, four movement patterns must be identified. 1 for hand open, 1 for hand close, 1 for palm up, and 1 for palm down. When using the bionic hand, additional movement patterns can be added later. To get a better idea of the phantom hand movements, advise the user to mirror the movements with their contralateral hand. Each phantom hand movement creates a particular movement pattern. The goal is to find a pattern for each prosthetic movement that is well separated from the other movement patterns. Once four suitable movement patterns have been found, they can be recorded in the test set. Before recording, navigate to the Myo Cuff menu and select whether a Myobock or a bionic hand is to be displayed and simulated. To verify if the previously selected movement patterns can be separated by Myo Plus, they have to be recorded in the menu Basic Set. Adjust the pause time between the individual movements. Within the pause time, the user has to prepare for the next movement. A longer pause time is recommended for new users. With a Myo Cuff, it is advisable to record a test set, which consists of just two recordings in the 90-degree bent arm position. After recording the test set, the shape of the recorded patterns will be displayed in color in the spider plot, and the prosthesis movements can be simulated and tested. If the patterns are separable, they can be used for the basic set of the interims or definitive prosthesis. If they are not separable, alternative phantom hand movements need to be identified and a new test set has to be recorded. To start the recording, make sure the arm is bent 90 degrees and press the green arrow next to Set 1. For each set, 5 movement patterns must be performed in the following order. Relax, hand open, hand close, supination, pronation. The blue bar shows the expiring pause time. During this phase, the muscles must relax and the user must prepare for the upcoming movement shown in the image. Start the recording by pressing the play icon. If the user needs more preparation time, the recording can be paused and continued with a green play button. The electrode signals are recorded during the red phase. In the first red phase, when the relaxed symbol is shown, the user must keep the muscles relaxed so that the resting EMG in the given arm position is recorded. Throughout the subsequent red phases, the user must perform the displayed phantom hand movements as follows. The user should start with a relaxed phantom hand. In section 1 and 2, the phantom hand should be positioned. In section 3 and 4, the contraction strength should be continuously increased up to 80% of the maximum contraction strength. The continuous increase of the contraction strength is important for the proportional control of grip speed and grip force. In case the user makes a mistake, cancel the recording and record the set again. Instead of an image of the movement, the spider plot can also be displayed. To toggle this feature on or off, use the switch at the bottom of the page. The display of the spider plot during the recording is used to check whether the currently executed movement pattern corresponds to the previously defined movement pattern. Set 1 is now recorded. Repeat the same recording process for set 2. Once set 1 and set 2 are finished, select both and press Creating a Test Set. This merges set 1 and set 2 to a test set, which is then stored temporarily in the Myo Cuff. Keep in mind that the test set is lost after switching off the Myo Cuff. The user can now test the reliability of the control in real time by displaying the spider plot or movement display. The spider plot now displays the patterns of the test set in different colors. Each colored pattern controls a prosthesis movement. The red pattern corresponds to hand open. The blue pattern to power grip or key grip, depending on the thumb position of the bionic hand. The orange pattern to palm up. And the green pattern to palm down. Now, let the user reproduce the phantom hand movements. Advise the user to mirror the movements with their contralateral hand. Inform the user if you notice deviations between the performed phantom movements and the movements that were recorded in the test set. Compare the current gray movement pattern to the recorded colored pattern. Pay attention to whether they look similar. When the current movement pattern is recognized as a prosthesis movement, the colored pattern is highlighted and the associated prosthesis movement is displayed below the spider plot. When training particular movement patterns, it can be helpful to deselect other patterns. Then only the selected patterns are displayed. In case the user forgets the performed phantom movement, it can be described in a free text form. This help text is displayed in different areas in the app. The test set can also be evaluated with a movement display, which is displayed by swiping left. When carrying out a phantom hand movement, the recognized prosthesis movement is shown in the middle, and the red bar indicates the current contraction strength. Instead of an image of the movement, the spider plot can also be displayed. Use the movement display and the spider plot to evaluate the prosthesis control together with the user. Encourage the user to perform all recorded phantom hand movements from the test set. If Myo Plus reliably recognizes the desired movements, use these phantom hand movements for the interims or definitive prosthesis fitting. If Myo Plus is unable to detect the desired movement, this can be due to two reasons. Reason 1. The movement patterns are too similar and Myo Plus cannot distinguish them. In this case, find alternative phantom hand movements and record a new test set. Reason 2. The user performs a different hand movement as recorded in the test set. In this case, encouraged the user to perform the correct phantom hand movement. Note that this type of prosthesis control is a new experience for the user and requires effort in the beginning. If necessary, take a longer break before the test to prevent muscle fatigue. To test whether the user can control additional bionic hand movements, navigate to the Add Pattern screen. In the Add Pattern screen, additional recordings for other available movements of the bionic hand can be added to the test set. Discuss with the user which bionic movement should be added. In this example, the pinch and column grip. Before recording, a new separable movement pattern must be identified for this grip. Therefore, navigate to the Spiderplot and evaluate a new movement pattern which is different from the already recorded colored movement patterns. If this separable movement pattern is found, navigate to the Add Pattern screen. Select the checkbox next to the respective movement and tap Continue to recording. Make sure the arm is in the 90-degree bend position like in the test set and start the recording. After the recording, the new movement will appear in the list of recordings. Added recordings can be deleted by selecting the checkbox and clicking on the trash can symbol. As clinician, it is also possible to lock a recording so that the user cannot delete it. To do this, click the checkbox twice until the lock symbol appears. After recording, the new movement is displayed in the spider plot. Now test with a spider plot or the movement display if Myo Plus can separate all movements. If the control is reliable, the phantom hand movements can be used for the interims or definitive prosthesis. If the control is not reliable, try to find alternative phantom hand movements. The evaluation with a Myo Cuff should give a good indication on how many patterns a user can produce. If the user can benefit of the Myo Plus control, the next step is to create an interims or definitive prosthesis.